Hi, my name's Scott the Miniature Maniac, and today we're going to paint some custom Blood Knights. What up, mini family? We haven't had a good old-fashioned, crunchy, just painting miniatures video in quite a while, so let's fix that. A few videos ago, I converted some Blood Knights for my Legion of Blood army. I also painted them up in a 38-hour painting spree. I didn't go over the specifics of painting those Blood Knights in that video, and a few of the viewers were curious, so... Inspired by the box art for the Blood Knights, I wanted to do some paint chipping. This also allows for me to slack on blending with the armor because the added texture is visually interesting enough to debatably not need a ton of fancy blends. That being said, I started with a base tone of scale 75's black metal, which is a cold, dark blue metal. I knew in the future blue was going to play a role in my paint scheme, so I wanted my metal to gravitate toward that, considering so much of the model is going to be red due to its armor. I then sponged on a much brighter silver to get a varied metal undercoat. My thinking here was that when I chipped the paint off, it would show a more interesting metal than just one flat coat. Once that was done, I put on the chipping medium, and I thinned it with airbrush thinner and applied 2 to 3 thin coats of it. The more coats you apply, and the thicker they are, the more of a chipping effect you'll get. I ensured this was dry to the touch after about 20 to 30 minutes of waiting and applied my scarlet color, which was a 50-50 mix of red and magenta from Chimera. I followed this up with some highlighting, which was done with an airbrush by taking some of the base tone and mixing in some white and some yellow. The yellow is there to maintain the saturation of the highlight while still increasing the value or the brightness. I'm focusing on the upper parts of some armor plates and not necessarily thinking too hard about what would be realistic. Sometimes just having a sexy transition on a big armor plate like we have here on this cavalry is very eye-catching despite not being entirely realistic. After that, I applied some shadows, which was simply a mixture of the base tone and some black. Once I had finished with the shadows, I realized that I had lost a lot of that rich scarlet midtone. Now normally if this happens, I just enliven my color with a little bit of ink, in this case applied through an airbrush. But considering later I was going to be abrading the surface with paintbrushes and toothpicks to get that chipping going, I decided against this because ink tends to be a little weak. Instead, I decided to goose my red color with pure red from Chimera, an acrylic paint instead of an acrylic ink. Once that step was done, I could begin the magical chipping, which started out a little bit slow. Despite waiting a maximum of an hour after applying the chipping medium, it was still kind of problematic. It's possible I thinned the medium too much, I didn't apply enough layers of it, or maybe I applied too much scarlet paint on top of it. Either way, what I discovered worked was to first weaken the surface of the paint with a toothpick, and then it'd come off much easier with a brush and some water. This kind of chipping definitely takes longer than other methods, like sponging on silver paint, but it creates a look that is markedly better in my opinion. There's almost an undeniable realism to the types of chips you get versus these other methods. Once that was done, you'd think it was time to varnish and seal all the stuff in, but I waited on that and instead moved on to base coating all the metallics, and boy, were there a ton. I spent probably close to 10 to 15 hours exclusively base coating metallics. I chose to have a variety of metallics like dark blues, silver, bronze, and copper. Having more of a variety of metallics creates a better end product, and you might claim that it slows the painting down. That might be true, but it can't be by much. The only time I'm losing is opening another pot, putting paint on my palette, and then thinning it a bit. Aside from that, I'm still applying paint in all the same areas. Considering this, I'm okay with going the slight extra mile to have a better end product. The reason why it's a better end product is showing love in the form of varied colors on the diverse details of your miniatures often looks better so long as your scheme is good. You can't just add colors willy-nilly. If you need help with creating schemes for your minis, check out the video linked in the top right-hand corner of the screen. Once I had that done, the majority of my base coating for the knights was complete, and then finally I hit it with a gloss varnish to seal in the chipping medium. I wanted to wait until I had base coated everything I was planning on washing with black in the next step, so they'd all be nice and glossy. Looking back, this was probably unnecessary considering the metallics are already glossy. With the varnish dried, I then applied my black gloss wash. Now, you may be asking at this point,
Scott, I thought we hated glossiness. Why are you using it so much?
It's my untested opinion that having both a glossy surface and a glossy product allows for the wash to collect in the recesses better, thus functioning better as a wash. Once that was dried, I hit my mouth with a semi-satin, semi-matte varnish to bring it back to a finish that I'd be happier with for the end result. Now, mostly everything was washed black, aside from the cool winged details on their shields, which I washed blue to further emphasize the cold elements of the knights. Now I was on to hiding some of the metals, and I wanted to do this now because I plan on dry brushing the chainmail elements, which can get a little bit messy. For the other metallic details, like the endless trim or the shield details, I did more of a focused application of highlights. Nothing particularly fancy, just some very quick layers to add some contrast. Once that was all done, I began painting some cloth. I chose a warm off-white color here because, in my mind, the majority of my scheme was warm, and I wanted to stay in that color temperature, allowing the blue elements to really pop out. I started with a simple base coat and then moved on to applying brighter highlights with a little bit of feathering and glazing. This process is fairly tedious, but was essentially multiple passes of very thin layers to build up the opacity of the white. I was saving the faces of the vampires for last, so I moved on to base coating a bazillion other details like the flesh of the horse, the fur, various belts and saddles. It seemed endless. I gave all these details at least one simple highlight. For instance, with the black horse flesh, I applied a mid-tone gray with no blending at all. It's very stark. If you make a stark highlight like this too bright, it'll look a little awkward, but just dark enough and it works. Now we can finally paint the faces. I was super happy with what I chose to use. I mixed a gradient of Abyssal Blue from Scale 75 and Cadian Flesh Tone from Citadel. The blue obviously killed any life my skin tone had intentionally. These vampires are dead after all. I slowly added more and more highlights, mixing in more and more Cadian flesh. Once I got to the very end, I was also adding white, which further desaturates the flesh tone, which may at the very end of your highlighting be getting a little too vibrant to be dead people. I really liked how this worked. The shadows were mostly matte and it transitioned into a more of a satin highlight, which might be hard to see on camera. Lastly, I added some bright teal eyes. I base coated with a simple turquoise and then added a highlight with a little bit of white mixed in. These eyes were the cherry on top of finishing an exhausting 33-hour paint job. I'm really happy with how my Blood Knights turned out. I enjoyed the conversion process and how they ended up looking with paint on them. I might try to expedite the process for the next five that I have to paint. If you guys have any ideas of how I could speed up the process, let me know in the comment section. And now, on to the sponsor for this video. Just kidding, I don't have a sponsor, just a friend who's doing a cool project that I want you guys to know about. So Emil from Squidmar Miniatures, a YouTube channel that you probably know about, recently launched a Kickstarter where he's selling a bunch of awesome brushes and sick busts. The brushes you can find in Emil's Kickstarter are Natural Hair Kalinske brushes, which if you don't have a pair of those in your painting arsenal yet, it's a great tool to pick up. I was actually using his brushes while painting my Blood Knights and my Direwolves during my painting marathon, and they hold up great, just like I would expect them to operate. He also has five really cool busts sculpted by legendary people like Joaquin Palacios and painted by awesome painters like Rodrigo Acore. They're super cool. Definitely check them out. I'll have the campaign linked in the description below for you guys to go and check out. Seriously, go support him. I love ML. I love his channel. He's doing great stuff and I want to see him succeed. That's going to do it for this video, guys. Thanks for hanging out and listening to me talk about my Blood Knights, my vampire obsession. Subscribe or die! But most importantly, don't forget to paint my minis!